Hello, it's Arit here. Welcome to another video on the Estetino Artist channel where we help you simplify your marketing so you can amplify your results and make more money doing what you love. In today's video, I'm going to share 7 ways for you to make money online as a creative entrepreneur. And all of these things that I am sharing are things that I've experienced, I've tried out myself, or I'm still doing them. I've tested them out and they actually do work. And I myself am a multi-passionate creative entrepreneur. So I'm not only a YouTube creator and coach as well. I also do graphic design. I am a worksheet designer. I'm a music artist. So what I'll do is I'll explain each of these things. We'll go through all 7 of them together. And I want you to stick around to the end of the video because if any of these interest you, I'll let you know what the next steps are and what you need to do to dive into it deeper. All right, so 1, start a YouTube channel. Of course, I'm going to say that, right? But I'm saying that because you can literally start a channel on absolutely anything that you are passionate about and you can make money from it. And I know that because I've mentored many channels on all different kinds of topics. And really, the secret to making money on YouTube and growing a successful channel is to create content that either educates and or entertains. And as long as you're passionate about the content that you create and you continue learning about the platform itself and how to be successful on YouTube, you can absolutely build an audience, earn monthly revenue from the channel, and also have it be a marketing platform for you and promote your products and services. And there are many different ways to monetize on YouTube, by the way. We did a presentation on this. There's seven different ways, maybe even more, to monetize on YouTube. The most common way that people know is making money through ad revenue. So in order to start doing that, your channel needs to meet YouTube's requirements for monetization. So you have to hit 1,000 subscribers on your channel and 4,000 watch hours. And once you hit those requirements, you can start to earn ad revenue. So anytime someone clicks on an ad or watches an ad, there's different ways to earn revenue from the ads. But that's when your channel starts to earn money. But the thing is, you can start earning money even before you hit the 1,000 subscribers. Not through ads, but through other ways. People donating to you. You can sell your products and services off of YouTube. You can sell merchandise. You can earn affiliate income, which is, I'm skipping ahead, but that's one of the ways that we're going to talk about in this video. So you can earn in so many different ways even before you hit YouTube's requirements for monetization. It's a massive form of leverage that builds your audience, promotes your brand, and generates money for you all in one. All right, so 2, since we already kind of touched upon it, you can earn affiliate commissions. So affiliate income allows you to earn from promoting someone else's product or service. And in some cases, you don't actually need to directly promote the product or service. And I'll give you an example. So we create different social media tutorials on the channel, stuff about content creation, just videos in general, helping creative entrepreneurs grow their business and succeed online. And in every single description of our videos that we have, we put a list of our gear that we use to create our videos. And you may have seen this from other YouTube channels as well. So we're not necessarily promoting our gear or talking about it in the video, but it's in the description and people do click on those links because they want to know what you're using to film your video or for your microphone. And those links are Amazon affiliate links. So you can set up your own Amazon affiliate account for free and whatever products you choose to promote or talk about, you can get your own personal affiliate links for those products. And when someone clicks on that and purchases your product from you, you'll earn a commission. But the cool thing is with the Amazon program is that they get cookied. So if they click on your link and decide, no, I don't want to buy that microphone that I just clicked on, but I want to keep browsing on Amazon and buy this book over here. Because they came through your link, even though you didn't promote the book and they decide to purchase the book, you will still earn a commission off of that. And because Amazon sells literally anything and everything, you can earn affiliate commissions on anything that you use as well. So think about if you're a photographer, think about the gear that you use and that you recommend to people. If you're a painter, what about the canvas or the paints that you use or the brushes? If you're a singer, your recording equipment, your lyric book even. And you can earn commissions on anything. And it's not just Amazon, by the way, or most brands nowadays have their own affiliate program. So for example, I often design websites for my clients and I recommend that they use Bluehost for hosting. And anytime they use my link to purchase Bluehost hosting for their website, I earn $100 commission off of that. And you just need to sign up for that affiliate program with that company and start earning commissions on whatever products and services that you recommend. Number three, you can create an online course on your craft or teaching a particular skill. So we have a client right now that we're coaching for YouTube, or she's a YouTube coaching client. We're helping her grow her channel. And she has courses on how to draw different characters and animals. She did the work to create the video lectures once. What you typically do is create a curriculum and break down your course into steps for people. Film each video, think about what other materials you can add in the course, like a worksheet perhaps, or a checklist. And you basically do the work to create this once, put it online, and it will sell for you over and over again. This is something that's really hot right now. Everyone and their mother is creating a course, and I literally mean that because last week was checking up on a guru that sells his courses online, and his mother created a course. I thought that was pretty funny. But it's a source of passive income. So think about what it is that you do well that you can teach to others. And you can put your course up on, there's so many different platforms out there. We use and have used Udemy. We've also used Skillshare. Skillshare is actually a platform that specializes in creative courses. So if you have a creative skill, they love courses like that. And as well, once you start to get a student base from people taking your course, you're actually promoting yourself as an artist or as a creative as well. So your products and services can also be promoted alongside them learning from you. Okay, number four. If you are in e-commerce, meaning you sell physical products, you can sell your stuff on a creative marketplace like Etsy, for example. You can also sell on eBay, or there's other specific marketplaces like Creative Market. For example, Creative Market allows you to sell digital products. So if you're a graphic designer, or if you work a lot with Adobe Illustrator to create templates, whether those are social media, graphic templates, or worksheets, or planners, or kits, media kits. If you're trying to target customers who really value quality, exclusivity, and artisanal handmade type products, even vintage products, then Etsy might be the right platform for you. eBay, of course, is like a behemoth of a platform. They have a whole range of products, but the whole idea here is to do research and find a marketplace that suits your particular product and your audience as well. And this is going to be more profitable, at least in the beginning, in putting your products, listing your products on a marketplace that already has existing traffic is going to work more to your favor and to your advantage than trying to set up everything on your own, setting up your own website, and then trying to figure out how to send traffic there. All of these marketplaces, Etsy, Creative Market, eBay, they already have existing traffic on there. So all you need to do is list your items, make sure you're titling and doing keywords in your description and everything, play by the rules of that platform to get found, give great customer service, great reviews, and you will succeed on that platform. Of course, I'm giving you general advice because every single platform has a specific way of succeeding on there, but you get the idea. Okay, moving on to number five, you can create and sell merchandise using print on demand. So this might be specifically for my graphic designers out there, but it doesn't have to be that you're good at graphic design. You can even outsource this. But the whole idea here is you are able to sell your designs on any type of merchandise that you can think of, and you don't have to own that inventory. So you don't have to own your t-shirts, your mugs, and all that kind of stuff with your design on it. And when I say own, I mean like physically inventory in your house. What you can do is just upload your designs to a platform like Printful or Printify. And then when the customer purchases from your site, and you know, they decide they wanna purchase your design on a t-shirt, that platform will print the item when it's ordered. So it's made to order, and that's why it's called print on demand. They'll print it then and there, and then they will ship it out to the customer. So you don't have to deal with any inventory, and they take care of that. This can be really cool. You know, if you're an artist or an illustrator, you can digitize your work and create merchandise out of it and use print on demand so that you don't have to do things the old school way and have all of your merchandise with you. No, it's made when it's ordered. And we did this as well because I've, you know, designed different things. I like to design different text graphics and cool icons and stuff. So we did this with Merch by Amazon. Amazon has their own print on demand platform called Merch by Amazon. So you literally, all you need to do is just upload your designs. There's already existing traffic on Amazon, right? So when they purchase that, Amazon will just ship it out directly to the customer. You can do this even on Etsy too. You can connect your Etsy store to a manufacturer or print-on-demand manufacturer like Printful or Printify, and once the order is made on Etsy, Printful, this is what we did, Printful will send the item to the customer directly. And we've made a lot of sales that way on both of those platforms. All right, number six. So if you're a service-based business, so you provide some sort of service, maybe it's graphic design, you're a web designer, or literally anything, you can turn any creative talent into a service, then what you can do is, once again, instead of promoting things on your own website, trying to get traffic to your website, start off by putting your services on a platform like Fiverr or Upwork. So these are different freelance websites where you can earn a healthy monthly income because they already have all of this existing traffic. People know those websites as places to get creative talent. So I actually had a gig on Fiverr, we had a few gigs on Fiverr for a couple years, and we were generating at one point $5,000 a month. So you can do the same thing. Take your creative talent, turn it into a gig or a service for someone. How can you be of value for someone? And the key thing to succeed on these freelance platforms is make sure you over deliver to your customers, because reviews are everything. And finally, the seventh way that you can earn money online as a creative entrepreneur is to turn your creative talent into an online event of some sort. So turn it into a workshop. Set up your camera in your studio and host a Zoom workshop where you're showing people how to make a candle or whatever it is that you do. You can turn it into an online event. So it's kind of similar to an online course, except it's a one-time thing. You're just creating the one video and it's live. An example of this that we did was an Airbnb experience. In addition to finding accommodations on Airbnb, they also do experiences, and now specifically online experiences. So what we did, because we're passionate about YouTube, we hosted an Airbnb experience that was all about hanging out with YouTubers for the day and find out more about what it's like to be a YouTube channel owner and a YouTube creator. So we would show people our gear. We would talk to them about, you know, what it takes to create videos and how that whole thing works. They would ask us questions. And if you just go on Airbnb experiences and type in your particular, whatever it is that you do, you'll start to get ideas, because you'll see people on there who host like cooking experiences, drawing, outdoor experiences. There's so many. You'll get some really good ideas just by browsing on there. And once you put your experience up, you fill out your listing and everything. Again, because there's already existing traffic on Airbnb, people will find your experience and will book online with you. And again, you're doing what you love, you're interacting with other people, and that's another way to generate revenue for you. So for each of these things, if any of these ways that we talked about in this video has piqued your interest, then head down to the description, because I have a full list of resources for you. So look up the one that resonated with you most, or maybe it's more than one, because you can do a combination of these things, right? And underneath each one, I have a list of either videos or downloadable guides or other websites that you can check out. So make it your goal to watch, read, or download the associated resources for any of these things and start taking action. And if you found this video helpful, please do hit the like button so that you can let others know that this video is worth their time. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.